This meeting.
Hi, my name is Ryan Jones. I'm a senior project manager at TPGI, and I'm also a JAWS user. Today, I'm going to show you a brief example of using JAWS on a web page. We'll show a good example of a web page that has accessibility built into it, and then an example of what happens when you're on a web page that does not have accessibility. These samples are made by the W3C, who also makes the web standards. So I have Google Chrome open and JAWS running. And I'm just going to start down arrowing through part of this particular web page, and we'll hear what JAWS says.
Heading level 2 navigation menu. List of 4 items.
So JAWS told me I just moved past a heading, and then it says I'm moving into a list with 4 items in it.
Link home.
Link home, which means this is a link that I could activate, and the name of the link is home.
Link news.
A link called news.
Visited link tickets.
A link called tickets that I have visited before, so it says visited link.
Survey.
The word survey, which is not a link, it's just text.
List end.
And then I'm at the end of the list. If I keep down arrowing.
Heading level 1 City Lights Survey.
I get to a new heading called City Lights Survey.
Heading level 2 This Week's Survey. More city parks a pain or a gain?
So if I continue to arrow down, I'll move through the survey. But I'm going to jump forward and find the edit boxes where I know there's some information that I will need to type in. So I'm going to press a JAWS shortcut key to let me do that.
Name, edit has pop-up menu.
And JAWS said name, and it says that it's an edit box so that I know that I could type something in here if I needed to. If I continue to move forward through these fields.
Email address, edit has pop-up menu.
There's one for email address.
Retype email, edit has pop-up menu.
I need to retype the email.
Submit button.
And this the submit button. There's another way that I could bring up a list of all of the form fields on this page, assuming that they are labeled properly.
Select a form field dialog. List 1 list view, submit button, 15 of 15.
And I'm at the bottom of the page. If I scroll up the list, I'll find all the form fields there. The names will make sense because this page does have accessibility built into it.
Escape.
Now I'm going to switch over to this similar page, same page, but it's going to not have accessibility built into it.
Welcome to City Lights, inaccessible survey.
So this is the inaccessible version. If I'm back on that same navigation menu on this page where there's things that are not done properly, let's hear what JAWS says.
Unlabeled graphic img/nav/home on mouse over.
So this was the thing on the other page that said home link. Now it's giving me a bunch of gibberish.
Unlabeled graphic img/nav/news on mouse over.
So these are images here in this navigation menu that are not properly labeled, so JAWS doesn't know what to call them.
Unlabeled graphic img/nav/facts on mouse over.
And I'm just pressing the down arrow key.
Unlabeled graphic img/nav/survey on mouse over. Citylight survey. This week's survey. More city.
JAWS did not tell me that there were headings here because this text was not marked up with the heading tags. In a similar example, if I bring up the same list of form fields that I used on the previous page.
Select a form field dialog. List 1 list view. Unlabeled 1 combo box quick menu. 1 of 14.
Instead of the nice properly labeled form fields that I had on the other page.
Radio button not check. Radio button not check. Radio button not check.
I'm not getting any labels on these particular form fields because they were not properly labeled for accessibility.
Escape.
As the screen reader user, I can use all kinds of different shortcut keys to move around this page, move to different form fields, links, buttons, headings. All of those things that I can move to, though, have to have been coded properly for accessibility in order for the shortcut keys to work and in order for JAWS to read the information.